Babe, will you say hi?
Hi.
Hi. Say, hi, fam. Yeah. Well, hey, fam, it is great to be with you. Mabel's super glad that she gets to be a part of today's devotional video. She's probably going to be super distracting. Right, May? Yeah. Today, I want to take some time to answer one of the questions we couldn't get to from last Sunday's message. If you weren't with us Sunday during worship, Joanne had a great idea that we could, with our streaming reality, we could ask people questions or give people an opportunity to ask questions, and then we would answer them at the end of the service. So we did that, but we couldn't get through very many of the questions, and you had some great questions. So I want to take today to answer one of them. Mabel's shaking the video. There we go. And so somebody wrote in and said, hey, I oftentimes, there's been times in my life where I feel like I've heard God, but then I also go through long runs where I feel like God is silent. What does that mean, that God is silent? And I've felt that, and I'm sure almost all of us have felt that at different times, where we're praying, we're asking God to intervene, we're asking him to show up, and we get nothing. We get silence. Well, a lot of people have felt that, and I believe that Joseph felt that. Joseph, not Jesus' father, but Joseph in Genesis. Yeah, she loves the story of Joseph. Do you like Joseph? Yeah.
Abraham.
Okay, no. So there was Abraham, Isaac, Jacob. Jacob had 12 sons. Milk, we're going to get milk later. And one of them is Joseph. Now, this is before Moses. This is before they'd been given the law. So they didn't have like really a formalized kind of like religion, I guess. I mean, they just had like stories of what happened to dad and granddad and great granddad, where God intervened and showed up, right? Where God showed up and passed between the halves of animals and made a covenant with Abraham. Times where there was a wrestling match with God, or God rescued Isaac from the altar. Stories like that where God intervened and shows up. Well, Joseph, I think he was probably hoping that God was going to show up on the day that his brothers betrayed him. You can read through Genesis 37 and get the whole story there. We're just going to look at a couple different parts of it specifically, though. Genesis 37, verse 17. Joseph went after his brothers and found them near Dothan. He was going to take care of his brothers, tend on them, check on them for dad. And they were in this city, Dothan. And Dothan's only mentioned twice in the Old Testament. We'll get to the other one in a moment. The brothers saw him at a distance, and before he reached them, they plotted to kill him. It's a super dysfunctional family. They hated Joseph so much. Well, I'm going to skip ahead to verse 23. When Joseph came to his brothers, they stripped him of his robe. The word stripped here is the same word that you would use for skinning an animal. It was violent the way they ripped this coat off of their brother. When Joseph came to his brothers, they stripped him of his robe, the ornate robe he was wearing, and they took him and threw him into the cistern. The word threw here is the same word you would use of a dead animal or leaving something for dead. The cistern was empty and there was no water in it. Now, we know later in Genesis, as the brothers retell the story, that Joseph was crying. He was sobbing and weeping as his brothers did this to him. I think he was crying to them, and I wonder if he was crying to God, hoping that God would intervene, hoping that God would show up. If you know the rest of the story, the brothers, they end up selling him into slavery. They see a caravan of people coming by and they sell their brother and get 20 pieces of silver for him. The other time where Dothan, the city where this happened to Joseph, the other time where that shows up in scripture is 2 Kings 6. And there's a moment when Elisha is facing opposition and his life is at stake and he calls out to God, and God shows up with chariots of fire. Wouldn't you love it if God could show up in the midst of your circumstance and respond to your prayer with chariots of fire? Like, that's incredible. I find it fascinating that here in this city, this one place that's mentioned just these two times in scripture, you get the extreme of chariots of fire and you get silence. Like, God didn't say anything. In fact, this is a chapter in scripture where God's not even mentioned. And the thing that's so fascinating to me with all of Joseph's story, you read through his whole account in Genesis, and you never really see God show up in the like divine ways of these incredible miracles. Joseph interprets some dreams, but other than that, there's nothing really where you would go, oh my gosh, look, there's God. But as you read through Joseph's story, what you see throughout there is that he believed that God was with him. Joseph lived with this steady confidence in the midst of all the things that he goes through in his life, false imprisonment because of false accusations and so many hard things. And then even the challenges of him being basically the king. I mean, leadership is hard. And all through the trials that Joseph faced, he lived with this steady confidence that God was with him. And his life looks a lot like mine and yours. There is not parting of the Red Seas. There aren't chariots of fire. It's just life is happening around you. And he had this confidence that God was with him. Like he's going through this life and he recognized that God was with him all along the way. And the thing that we have that Joseph didn't is that we have a better story than just God is like around or God is with us. We have Christ in us. Because Jesus was betrayed for 20 pieces of silver and gave his life for us and has given his life to us. So while we pray, when we experience silence, it isn't the absence of God. Just because God is silent doesn't mean that he's absent. Christ, Jesus, he's in you. He's with you. He's for you and he has you. And so I want you just to answer this question. Would you do anything different if you had the full confidence that God really is with you? You pray and it's silent, but would you do anything different? Would you act different if you really knew that God was with you? What's wrong? You all right? Okay, we're fine. Sometimes you just need sympathy, right?
Yeah.
So friends, just because God's silent doesn't mean he's absent. In fact, we have Christ with us and he's in us. And so as you pray and as you experience silence, still live with the steady confidence that Christ is with you and that God is always working for his glory and your good, and trust him.